Fox 11 in Tucson. You and the rest of the country are watching Fox After Breakfast. On today's show, comedy master Gary Marshall. His TV and film work has kept us laughing for years. Welcome. We'll meet some rags-to-riches dogs as our Amazing Animals Week continues. Nervous about reunions? I am. Our shrink Sheena Hankin has helped for us all. And actress Kelly Rutherford's here. She's a vixen on Melrose Place. I'm your announcer, Nancy Giles, with Road Warriors Jeff McGregor, Bill Cogan, and Suzanne Huang. And here's your host, Tom Bergeron, with special guest, the lovely Kim Cole.
And the lovely Tom Bergeron. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Kim is even more lovely, if you can imagine that today, because of what she has adorning her neck.
Ooh.
Check this out. This is... Oh, that's the perfect music,
oh,
Rob.
My.
Thank you. This is the first time on American television that this 70-carat Excelsior 1 gem has been seen. It is the centerpiece of Dazzling Diamonds, an exhibition of rare diamonds traveling across the country all by themselves to celebrate Harrah's Entertainment's 60th diamond anniversary.
Look, it looks like the Home Shopping Network when I do this.
That's right. We only have a limited supply left, so call now.
It's about $4 million, and not sure how much.
Just this part.
Just the diamond.
Wow.
Just that part.
We have, and they've asked not to be shown on camera. We have about 20 ninjas that were sent over with this diamond.
Making sure that I don't run, as if I could outrun these guys.
Very serious people, very sort of, you know,
checking me out.
People. Yes. And I'm sure we can really, there's the Brinks truck that the diamond can. See, now here's somebody mentioned this, Kim.
Yes.
Before the show, if I may be critical of the people who brought this diamond from Harrah's and the Moab family, I think they're going about it all wrong.
I think they should just give it to me,
and one of them
should marry me. No, oh, I'm sorry.
They could do that, but it's a, you got a Brinks truck, you got 12 ninjas, you got, you know, sullen looking people, and obviously something's going on. What they should do is just have a guy dressed up in jeans and a Gap sweatshirt.
A guy named Mo.
Put it in your pocket, walk down, you know, singing gospel tunes. No one's going to touch you in New York.
Alone.
Just leave you alone, save a lot of overhead.
Hmm. Just a suggestion.
Just, yeah, an idea. But that's it. That's great.
Or you could give it to me and I'll wear it home and I'll walk down the street singing gospel tunes just wearing a sweatshirt. I mean, just a thought.
It could work. By the way, if you want to see the diamond in person, the tour starts May 29th at Harrah's Atlantic City. It ends at Harrah's Las Vegas in October. This is, I guess, a one-of-a-kind.
And Kim's neck not included.
Nancy, why don't you take this to your Oberlin College reunion?
I will, Tom, but let's just talk about that. Now, when you look at that necklace, doesn't it remind you of a special day and maybe a special person you like to say something or give something special to? Wink, wink, nudge, nudge. Tom?
This is my, thanks for that little nudge. I did remember, though.
Oh, good.
Did you remember?
It's my 15th anniversary today.
Yay, Tom and Lois.
Oh, that's nice. Thank you. And I know Lois is probably not watching because she's working the book fair at Cody and Cody's school right now. But I love you very much.
Oh.
Happy anniversary. 50. It's amazing. 15 years.
Wow. And you told me before that this is your best friend.
Definitely. Yeah.
Oh, that's
been
so
very
wonderful.
Cool. It's been very cool.
Very good.
So, yeah.
And Lois, he says he's going to give it to you. Okay. I'm spoiled
it all. I wasn't talking about the diamond.
Oh, hey. But
you.
I'll be here all week, try the veal. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
All right. Okay. All righty, where were we? Oh, yes. I'm blushing, actually, now. Let's go to our dining room table, because we have some people who also are going to help not only you, Nancy, get ready for your Oberlin College reunion this weekend, but are kind of responsible for you looking so nice
so
today.
So, spiffy. We have Dana Buckman and Karen Harmon. Fabulous designers.
Yes,
well
they
done. They designed for the American woman, not just a person who wears a size 6.
And
I appreciate
it.
And I obviously do not wear a size 6, honey. And it's very nice, very well, very tailored, very fabulous thing.
Very nice indeed. Well, and also nice. Sheena Hankin, our FX shrink. Oh, there's a flashback.
Whoop.
Our Fox After Breakfast shrink is here to help Nancy through all of the emotional travails that you'll no doubt be facing this weekend.
No doubt.
Right, Sheena?
That's right, Tom.
Okay.
Right, Kim.
All right.
Right.
Last night, here in New York City at Radio City Music Hall, the Daytime Emmy Awards went on. Susan Lucci continued her losing streak, unfortunately, but she was in good humor about it. And actually,
she's
Linda...
very classy. I wouldn't show up next year, personally. Watch, she'll win if she doesn't show
up.
Susan, don't go next year. It'll be yours. just a little thought.
Linda Dano, who is from another world, sort of anchored our coverage of the daytime Emmy Awards. Let's go to the videotape.
Hello, Tom. Welcome to the daytime Emmy Awards. You're going to see a lot of studs here tonight and a lot of beauty. Mwah. Lots of glamorous fashion.
Ah. Oh, cool. Very cool.
Look at that. The Aquaman look.
You'll see a lot of friends of Fox After Breakfast. Pay attention, Tom.
Hello. Fox After Breakfast.
Hi, Tom. Hi, everyone. Why aren't they here? Why's Tom here?
Yeah, hi, Tom. Hi, guys.
Tom. Hello, everybody. Fox After Breakfast.
Oh, I love that show. Hi, Fox After Breakfast.
Hey, hi, Tom.
Hey, Tom. Here's a big, juicy kiss from Pine Valley. Ready?
I got to run in now, Tom. I'm presenting. Back to you.
Thanks to Linda Dano for doing that. That
was lovely.
And congratulations to, let's see, Rosie won and Oprah won for Best
wonderful.
Show and all the
wonderful.
Other winners last night. Suzanne Wong, actually, you know, who's doing Amazing Animals Week this
yes.
week, gave Gary Marshall a piece of information that when he was last here that he did not know. And now he uses this regularly.
So I'm told.
Did you realize that, Suzanne?
No, I didn't know that.
Do you remember the piece of information you gave Gary Marshall?
Was it the Joni Loves Chachi story?
That's right, the Joni Loves Chachi story. That was on our FX incarnation. Can you reprise that for our network?
Are you
audience?
Serious?
Yeah.
You want me to tell?
Yeah.
Okay.
What does Chachi mean in Korean?
Well, Chachi means penis. So my parents, when they saw that show was coming on, they thought that was very funny.
I bet they did.
And so do we.
So where are you?
I am at the Big Apple Circus in Queens, New York, not kicking off, day four of Amazing Animals Week. And this is the Muttville Comics Troupe. 14 dogs, most of which were rescued from animal shelters. They're incredible. That lady jumping up and down. And because of the love of their trainers, they've been changed forever. Their lives have been changed for the better, and they're out of the animal shelters. Behave, you guys.
Is that dog just
want
to get out of there?
We're going to see them perform and find out about their trainers and the great work they're doing here.
Oh, come on, one more hop
to
the one in the barrel.
Come on, Mutt!
It's funny. It's like he had a timeout. The rest of them get to play with Suzanne.
Oh, that's right.
All right, that's all coming up from the Big Apple Circus. It's a pleasure to have Gary Marshall here.
Absolutely.
Because not only is he one of the most acclaimed television producers and film directors and nice guys in Hollywood. I mean, this is a class act. Kim and I were talking beforehand, but it's a pleasure to welcome him back. You also know him as Stan the Network Man on Murphy Brown.
All
please
right.
welcome Gary Marshall!
Marshall!
Hey! Hey, Grandma. Hello, mister.
We are not worthy.
Hello.
How are you?
How are
good
you?
To have you
good
back.
Good to see you.
Oh, you're shining in my eyes.
What else is happening on our little show today, Nancy?
All right, Tom, welcome, Gary. We're going to meet the steamy new star on Melrose Place, actress Kelly Rutherford, also known as Megan. She joins us later on Fox After Breakfast, so stay tuned.
After Breakfast is brought to you by Johnson's Clean and Clear skincare products. Clean and clear and under control.
Did you know Clean and Clear Deep Action Cream Cleanser has no oil?
Uh-huh.
Some cleansers do.
Yeah, I knew that.
But not Clean and Clear Deep Action Cream Cleanser. Most like it better than Noxzema. Clean and clear and under control.
Our bodies perspire in more places than one. That's why there's shower-to-shower body powder, to protect the rest. New Breeze Fresh shower-to-shower. Now 40% more absorbent 100% of the day.
On Super Bowl Sunday, the country watched another dream come true.
You just won $10 million from Publishers Clearinghouse.
$10 million?
Yes.
But now you don't have to wait until Super Bowl Sunday to become a millionaire. August 14th, the Publishers Clearinghouse Prize Patrol will surprise a new $1 million winner live on TV. Enter now when it could be you.
I believe that you and me last forever. All day, one hour of the night.
Jolly Rancher candy. Colossal fruit taste that lasts.
Our dentist says our mouths are full of plaque bacteria.
Bacteria? Gross!
The Crest Deep Sweep Toothbrush. Deep sweep bristles help sweep away bacterial plaque between teeth and along the gum line. Fits between to get teeth clean.
We're back, and Gary Marshall is here.
Yay!
With us.
Yay, I'm here.
TV legend.
Good morning. Good morning. Good morning.
Can I tell you, you're still out telling people that this is a good read, aren't you?
It's a good book, yes.
It's a fine book.
With Penny, my sister, and my daughter, Lori Marshall. You all do. About show business. It's, how to break in.
It's great, but I was saying to you during the break, the book's fine, but to get the full Marshall experience, you have to get the audio tape.
Well, I talk with a little accent, and Penny does the intro, and you get two whiny voices. Driving in your car, you hear, hi, how are you? Here's how you break in the show. Kind of keeps you going.
It does.
Calm. Nice to be here.
Good to have you.
Good to have
you. You look good. You got Dana Buckman.
I got free
somebody, Julie. Is anything yours? What you got? Anything. The
earrings. My underwear.
The underwear.
The earrings are
all right. The earrings
That's
are yours.
About it.
Okay.
And the hair. Yeah. It's rented. We'll talk.
Okay. It looks great. I'm happy. I got a wonderful show, and I'm here because my life is passing before me on Nick at Night.
Right. How do you feel about that? All these wonderful shows you created are popular again.
Yes, I don't know why. I guess they like family entertainment. Happy Days. Laverne and Shirley making its big debut on Nick at Night very soon. All because my mother said, couldn't you get Penny a job? She's running around. So Penny was on Odd Couple. And
right.
Now, of course.
Of course.
Cindy Williams and Penny on Laverne and Shirley. So we're looking to have that. Still a very funny show.
Can I give this statistic? Because this is amazing, and I don't think it's ever been achieved prior to this or since. In the week of January 28th, 1979, our guest had four of the top five TV shows on the air.
That's true. What a good week that was.
What a good week.
That had no complaining. No. It was Mork and Mindy, Laverne Shirley, Happy Days, and Angie was fourth.
Donna Pesco. Whatever.
They were on a couple of years. Yeah. We got the name right. But Joni Loveshot, she was not in that. That came later.
Although you had the Korean audience from everything.
Yes, she explained. Suzanne knows how to actually say penis in many languages. But because she told me that it was... I wondered why Korea we got such a high rating. But she explained
now you know.
It. We zoomed. You know, Thailand, Cambodia, Korea. Who?
That's exactly right.
But you learn. I go on these shows. It was very rewarding to, you know, you do your work. I've done other shows, TV Land, a new channel. They're going to show some of my bombs, being the chimp, the beauty. So you have good and bad, and it was really nice that some of the shows are still on.
Did you have any veto power with TV Land? Did you say, oh, not me and the chimp, please, just don't run that one again?
No, I think you got to bear yourself. It's this era. I grew up in the 50s. Everything's fine. There's nothing in my closet. Now we're the 90s, you're coming out. Here's my whole closet. This is my whole life. I once said I really like to get actors just as they're beginning. Mm-hmm. An actor just as he's beginning and before rehab. So I make a star. So this is, a part of me.
But what's great is that you act also.
Yes,
you
Murphy
you do it
Brown
too.
Picked up again.
Wonderful. Congratulations.
Kansas. I play a crazy network guy who has no... attention span.
Just like all of us.
Tom, I have nothing to say. I just want to see if I remembered your name. Hi.
Pretty much acting. I don't think you're acting, Gary.
No, it's actually I'm doing my father.
Okay.
Really?
My mother had a great sense of humor, gave Penny and I a sense of humor. Mm-hmm. My father had a sense of humor like this table. This is my father's never get. But he was a great boss, so we all learned to be bosses.
Well, we've got, I think we have a, is this a montage of moments of Gary Marshall appearing
sure
on
is,
several?
Sure is, Tom.
Okay, thanks, Nance. Let's take a look at Gary Marshall in action from some of his hit series.
I haven't been on a subway in 5 years.
I can't tell you how much we missed you.
That man's got a big mouth.
Don't talk to nuts on the subway.
Here's a nice-looking man. What's your name, sir?
Harry Hitt.
Get out of here.
You could have used Dana Buckman in that scene.
He's always a snappy dresser.
I'm always a snappy dresser. The subway show. Actually, it was a show almost didn't get done. Tony Randall hated the script because originally it was Putting Down New York.
Mm-hmm.
And I didn't know that. He was on the committee to make a better image for New York. So I'm putting on. So we made it a very positive show in the subway. Because I love New York.
I was thinking, actually, that this was going to be a montage of your musical moments from the series. Do we have that as well?
These musical. Are some
of sure Gary do, Marshall. Tom.
Yeah,
singing
thank you, man.
You're welcome.
The player from a horn. The rat-a-tee-tap.
Oh, I was playing the happy
I'll take you to form.
Here we go.
Now this is
this is it
from the Vernon Shirley,
the
right?
Vernon Shirley was Penny Bates.
Are you gonna play?
Yeah.
Wow.
Right. I worked most of my life.
Kimberly was asking.
Gary.
That's how I made a living.
Did you really?
Playing the drums.
Do you ever lose it?
Yes.
Do you?
Constant. I lost it when I was playing, but I was never great. There was a great drummer. My idol was Buddy Rich.
Oh, of course.
And they called me Buddy Poor. That was how they introduced me because I played to him. But I played for years all through college. I graduated from Northwestern because I could play the drums and made a living. In Korea, you got drums here. You're going to.
Uh-oh.
You want me to show everybody what bad chops I have. I could play something.
Ladies and gentlemen, Buddy Poor.
Buddy Poor, let's hear it.
Yes.
Buddy Poor. Here we go.
Right now.
We're walking over here.
We're walking over here.
Yeah. Breakfast is fun.
And we'll give you free food when you're done. That's what's great about this show, yeah?
Fox, I was so excited. Now, I was trying to impress Kelly Rutherford. She's not going to be impressed with this. So, this is the breakfast. Good morning. This is breakfast. Wake up. Very tired.
Hey! Gary Marshall!
Wake up time! That's Fox!
Check out Nick at Night in TV Land. The Gary Marshall tribute just goes on and on.
All right.
Can you?
Ladies and gentlemen.
Rim shot.
Can you play us to break as Nancy tells us what else is coming up? Just a little something from your repertoire.
Well, I have to play Underhush.
All right.
Thank you.
Go, Nancy.
All right. Thank you, Gary. Ladies and gentlemen, and children of all ages, stay tuned to the center ring for some amazing circus dogs. That's next on Fox After Breakfast.
Now there's a different kind of toothbrush.
Welcome back to Fox After Breakfast, live from New York City with Tom Bergeron, our special guest Kim Coles, and I think Gary Marshall's leaving?
Yes, he has miles to go before he sleeps.
We got to do a big thing for Nick at Night, the luncheon, so it's really a pleasure to be here.
How about a hand? One of the classic things.
Yay!
Yay! Thank you.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye, Gary.
Kelly Rutherford, I love her. Goodbye, the announcer girl.
Thank you. Thanks, Gary.
And Suzanne. Bye-bye.
I was mentioning to Gary that my daughters think that Happy Days is brand new because they're watching it on Nick at Night and they love the Fonz. It's like watching that whole film full circle.
Sit on it.
What does Fonzie mean in Korean, Suzanne?
Tom, what about my graphics?
This isn't the official setup. I just thought there was another nifty translation.
Well, here it comes,
Gary.
Because it's Amazing Animals Week. with Rogue Warrior Suzanne Wong. Take it, Suzanne.
Thank you very much. I'm going to ignore that question, Tom. I'm going to go right to, I'm here at the Big Apple Circus in Queens, New York, continuing our Amazing Animals Week. Check it out. Today I am with the Muttville Comics Troupe. They're an incredible group of circus performers that have been delighting thousands of children and adults all across the country. The great thing about this troupe is that most of them were rescued from animal shelters, some of them just days before they were going to be put to sleep. That's actually Tess. She's a greyhound that was rescued from a greyhound rescue program. She's a retired racer, and she's going to do another jump for us. Yay! They're incredible. Now, I am here with Johnny Pierce and Peggy O'Neill. They've been partners for 6 years, and this is the Muttville Comics Troupe behind us. Their dogs, Raging and Ange, from 1 year to 9 years old, and they're mostly mutts. Some of them are purebreds. Hi, Johnny. How are you?
Very good, thank you. So good to be here with Fox.
Now, you have been a clown for 25 years. How did the troupe originate?
It originated with one dog that I got out of a pound from Brewster, New York. Her name was Freckles. That was my clown partner.
Now, you use only positive reinforcement to train the dogs. What's the biggest challenge when you introduce a new dog into your troupe?
Probably getting the dog, because we don't know what his or her background is, used to the different sounds, the traveling, all the noise and excitement, and getting the dog used to all the other dogs.
Right. Now, I want to see what some of these animals can do. Who's our first performer?
That baby. Would be...
Hi, baby. Hi, baby. And this is Peggy.
Hi.
Okay, why don't we get baby going with baby's trick. What's baby going to do?
Baby will do a beautiful front handstand for you.
Now,
front
where did baby come from? Oh, look.
Oh, she's from up pound. Isn't she great? Nice.
Where'd she come from?
She's from up pound in Ohio, and her former parents were allergic to her, apparently. That's what the paper said. So we got lucky and got baby.
I see. So how do you feel about these dogs, Peggy?
Well, these dogs are our family. We don't have any children. These are our children. We live together 365 days a year, and we love them. We know them personally as individuals, and they know us.
So they're treated really well. This is Gilda. Hi, Gilda. Hi, beautiful. Oh, no, sorry. I'm distracting Gilda. Go ahead. Go ahead. I'm sorry. Gilda's going to do a trick for us. Where did Gilda come from, Peggy?
Gilda, who is named after Gilda Radner in the hopes that she will be the funniest girl around, is pronounced Gilda because she's from a pound in El Paso, Texas.
Okay. And where did you get Gilda? You got her in a pound, but wasn't she about to be put to sleep?
Yes. It's a very crowded pound. Unfortunately, they can't keep the animals long, and she was going to be destroyed the next day.
So thanks to you guys, she hasn't been. Now, Johnny, come over here. I want to ask you a question. I just want to know, do you ever get in situations, since animals are so unpredictable, that they won't perform?
You know, one time, Daphne, the basset hound, took off right into the seats during the act, and it was like five of us chasing her, trying to get her back on the seat. She was like her debut in show business.
So what did you do?
We just caught her, and we went on to the next trick.
Just keep on going.
That's right.
Now let's get you ready for the big finale. This trick, Tom and Kim, involves 6 of the 14 dogs.
Oh.
It took them 2 months to learn this trick. And actually, teaching your dog tricks builds confidence and self-esteem. Oh, look, go over the back. Yay!
Oh, that's they give up
great.
Quick.
If you want to see them performing live, they're going to be here at Queens Cunningham Park until May 25th. Then they're off to Cleveland and Chicago and New England. Thank you very much. Bye.
Take care. Thanks so much, Suzanne. Big Apple Circus. Kim took off. I don't know where. Anyway, right now, Uma Pemmaraju is at the Fox News Channel.
Good morning, everybody. Here's some of the stories making news today. The Nevada State Athletic Commission has knocked Mike Tyson out of the ring, revoking his boxing license as punishment for biting fellow fighter Evander Holyfield. Tyson must wait at least a year before he can try to get back the right to fight. Here's a word of warning to pregnant women. The calcium supplements you may be taking to ward off high blood pressure don't work according to the National Institutes of Health. Many take calcium to prevent a blood pressure condition called preeclampsia, which can kill both mother and her fetus. But now the largest study of its kind finds calcium supplements don't help at all. And pesticides can have an even worse effect. Women exposed to pesticides for 1 month in the early stages of pregnancy can increase their risk of having a stillborn birth by as much as 70%. Now, that study can be found in the Medical Journal of Occupational and Environmental Medicine. Supermodel Elle McPherson may have been the target of extortionists. In Los Angeles, at least one man is pleading innocent to charges of attempting to blackmail her, and another is accused of breaking into her home. The plot allegedly included plans to circulate some kind of personal photographs of her on the internet and expose a deep, dark secret unless she paid them off. No word yet on what that secret might have been. And today's celebrity birthday is one of America's most respected television newscasters. David Brinkley turned 77 today. Happy birthday, David. And that's the latest from Fox News Channel. Have a great day, everyone.
Okay, please, okay, turn the camera off. I don't know what happened. I went to the bathroom,
yeah,
and I was washing my hands. I took it off and put it on the counter, and I went back to the bathroom after I finished because I left it there, and it's gone.
It's a $4 million diamond.
I know, but, and maybe, I lost the necklace.
What
turn
kind?
The camera off, turn the camera.
What kind of person would steal a diamond like that?
None.
It would have to be somebody like.
Yes.
Yes. Kelly Rutherford from Melrose Place.
Next.
Why no, no, I after break.
Why I gotta. Why I.
Let's go teach her a thing or two.
Get that necklace from Kelly. Coming up, designers Dana Buckman and Karen Harmon are going to tell me what to wear to knock out my classmates at my college reunion this weekend. Stay tuned. Oh my God, on Fox After Breakfast.
We're back with the diamond stealing hussy
oh,
from Melrose.
My God. Can you believe this?
What does that
gorgeous
feel like, Kel?
Oh, it feels so good. This
feels
doesn't
right.
It?
Doesn't it feel right?
Doesn't, are you energized from where?
Absolutely.
I feel,
in fact, I feel like I need to get it back. We'll talk.
Uh-oh.
Well, that's how I feel. You really want to know how I feel.
If you're just joining us, what Kelly and previously Kimberly had on, it's the Excelsior One Diamond. The
yeah.
First time
Everybody
it's ever been seen.
Everybody put your sunglasses on.
It's 70, like, about 70 carats. It's worth, just the diamond itself is worth $4 million without the rest of the necklace and setting. How about that,
honey.
Huh? That'll
honey.
Help a trip
I
to Paris.
I love it. That's right. It's coming with me.
Yeah. Good to have you here.
Hi.
So explain the arc, if you will, of your character on Melrose Place. Just a typical small-town girl.
Typical small-town girl who got in a lot of trouble in Melrose Place.
Mm-hmm.
She starts out, she sort of comes in, Marcia hires her, you know, with Kimberly, who's married to Michael, to sort of come in and, you know, help her husband along. And so that
yeah,
was
right.
me.
In a very special way.
In a very special way. And we end up falling in love. Not Kimberly and I, but Thomas and
yeah.
I, Michael. And then things... I'm now married to Michael on the show.
So the hooker with a heart of gold.
Yes, exactly.
Yeah, you kind of glossed exactly. over the hooker part.
I know.
I'm sorry.
I'm not anymore. I've
right.
grown. So, yeah. But it's fun.
But didn't
fun
you just
show.
Get divorced? Or you left him?
Yes, sort of. It's the last
yeah.
show.
Yeah.
So I don't know what's going to happen. I haven't read the next scripts. I don't know.
Uh-oh.
I
okay.
love working with him.
Mm-hmm. I think we have a scene of you in action here.
Uh-oh.
From Melrose Place.
Do you have any concept of what you've done, how many lives you have ruined? Peters, Taylors, your own?
Guess. Well, it's just a case of never thinking I'd get caught.
Yeah, and that's supposed to make a difference. Yeah, you know, you are one sick puppy, Michael.
And you know what's worse? Is you don't even realize it. You know, I bet you would do it all over again if you thought you could get away with it.
Megan, oh, I'm sorry.
Yeah, so am I, Michael. Sorry I ever laid eyes on you.
Oh, boy.
Ouch.
Oh, boy.
What's he got the oven mitts on for?
And he's always funny. He could be dying, he could be anything. He's always funny.
He has a sense of humor all the time.
He does. He's wonderful. Look at all this actress-friendly food.
Well, you can't eat it.
No, don't.
Okay, you can't eat it because all the... people on Melrose, I mean, like, you know,
tiny.
And I, excuse
yeah.
me, I
no.
live near Melrose, the real Melrose, and not everybody has like a size 2 weight.
No.
And you can't eat this stuff.
No.
How do you fit into the clothing?
No, the first day I was on the show, they brought in this little outfit for me to wear, and I come screaming out of my trailer, you know, somebody put Heather's clothes in my trailer. I can't wear any. What are you kidding?
You know what? You know what? These
so
these
wonderful.
You can't eat.
No.
But we've got something you can. You bring on
okay.
The special cookies.
Oh my God!
We got special
diamonds
cookies. Thank you very
cookies?
Much.
I
these
like
are.
It. Is it love? I'm moving into this apartment.
Kelly, these are something we thought you'd like.
Do you know what? Those
what?
Are my favorite. Those taffy cookies.
They're from the Mother's Cookie Company.
Yes.
Yeah. Do you like?
And
do you like those?
Oh, no.
I think the only reason I think Kelly might go for the Mother's
no.
cookies is because. before she was the hooker with the heart. She and Matt LeBlanc of Friends sold Mother's Cookies. Let's go to that tape.
Mother's Cookies by the Scoop. Mother's Cookies by the Scoop. Milk, a fudge and chips. Brownie, nut, a sandwich, sandals, they all took a dip.
The best part's coming up. Watch this.
Mother's cookie lovers ice cream.
They were very
furry.
Oh,
very nicely.
I can't believe this.
Pick it up on this show.
Oh, this is so fun. No, we went to the, my mother actually was with me when we went to the audition, and she said, you two have to go in together. You just have to. And it was my first commercial I ever did.
We have the freeze of them together, just an image to go to break with. Kelly and Matt. Look, here's
Oh my God. These guys are amazing. I'll tell you.
Well, suck back a couple of cookies
All right,
on
here
us,
we go.
Kelly. We're going to take a break. Can you stick with us? Because we have a lot going on, and we have to get the diamonds back.
I'm feeling it.
All right, Nancy, what else is happening?
Well, I think I'm about to come up and show you what kind of clothes I should be wearing for my college reunion. I believe that's next on Fox After Breakfast.
I bite into a York peppermint patty, I get the sensation that I'm poised on the ice, my back to the goal, facing icy puck after icy puck, save, take save, and a beaut.
York peppermint patty, get the sensation.
Why do I always have pimples?
Pimples.
Pimples?
Ugh. Why do I always have pimples?
I tried stuff at night.
I tried scrubbing. Forget it.
I used that stingy liquid stuff.
And that prescription product says it could take weeks to work. Don't get mad. Get Clearasil. Clearasil cream sucks up oil, then zaps pimples dry. The choice is clear.
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 The choice is clear.
For clearer skin, the choice is Clearasil.
Now there's a different kind of toothbrush dogs love sinking their teeth into. Pedigree Dentabone. Its unique shape and texture helps reduce the accumulation of harmful plaque and tartar. Pedigree Dentabone. Developed with vets. Recommended by top breeders.
Children of sworn enemies.
Oh, I wish we could just stay here forever.
Caught up in a war.
You have poisoned my house.
Two star-crossed lovers an army could not destroy.
She belongs to us. Not anymore.
Their never-ending passion will begin.
From this life to the next.
With a roar. Premieres Monday at 9, 8 central.
It's 99 and it's incredibly hot. The one price, one weekend sale at Recreational Factory Warehouse. Pools, $99. Pool liners, filters, and pumps, $99. Ladders, pool cleaners, pool covers, even complete installation. Amazingly, just $99. The one price, one weekend sale. This weekend at Recreational Factory Warehouse, your authorized sun dealer. Windsor Square Shopping Center next to the theater, West Knoxville.
I'm Jackie Adair. I bet you've made a lot of changes in the past 5 years, and at Direct, so have we. Changes to make everything about car insurance easier and more affordable.
I couldn't believe how much money they saved me each month on my car insurance. My down payment was only $56, and my payments were only $36.
So if you haven't called us lately, or if you've never called before, you need to call now. You'll like the changes going on at Direct.
Don't suffer through another sweltering summer. Beat the heat with a big 15 by 24 family size pool from the Pool Depot for as little as $385. You're thinking $385, not a bad deal for a pool. But what about the installation? $385 includes installation on your ready site. $385 also, for a limited time, includes filter, pump, in-pool ladder, two sun decks with safety stairs, and a free solar cover. That's right, all that including installation, $385. Can you beat that? No, you can't. This is the summer you've waited for. The wife, the kids, relaxing around the pool, playing in the cool water. But we're wasting time. Call the Pool Depot now, 1-800-678-1133, and ask for your free yard survey. Tell them you want the works for $385 or ask how you can save over $2,300 on the top-of-the-line Elite model. But call now. You may never get a better chance to put a pool in your family's backyard. Just $385 while they last. Homeowners only, please.
The switch is on to Fox 43. Switch to Fox 43.
It's the Fox After Breakfast Coast to Coast Co-host Contest. On Friday, May 30th, we will announce four finalists who will be flown to New York City for 6 days of fun. Then you at home will be able to choose the lucky winner who will co-host with Tom for a day and drive away with a brand new Chevy Lumina with standard safety features you most want, and that gives you one less thing to worry about. Watch for details on when and how to cast your toll-free vote. Plus, everyone who entered will be able to win great vacation trips like a one-week vacation to Florida at Ramada Limited's Inns and Plaza Hotels. Or at Knights Inn. At Knights Inn, you'll spend less here so you can spend more there. A one-week vacation to Days Inn, Panama City Beach, Florida. Follow the sun to Days Inn. A one-week vacation to anywhere in the continental U.S. at Travel Lodge, home of Sleepy Bear's Den. Or at Howard Johnson. Howard Johnson makes you feel at home. Or a one-week European vacation at an RCI resort. RCI, the world's leader in vacation exchange. All of our fantastic trips include hotel, airfare, and car rental from Avis. Watch Friday, May 30th, to see who will win these great prizes. Plus, meet the four finalists. And get ready to cast your vote. It's the Fox After Breakfast Coast to Coast Co-host Contest.
Those dulcet tones were first heard on the campus 16 years ago of Oberlin College. Nancy Giles, our own announcer here in our mock Oberlin College campus, along with Kelly Rutherford, Sheena Henkin, and also, you know, no one has the done. And Kim Cole. Very nice.
I love the accessorizing with the headset. Now I just wear that to annoy you.
And we're here with Dana Buckman, right, and Karen Harmon of Dana B and Karen and Dana Buckman and the whole thing. And they make clothing that American women can wear.
That's right, women with curves like Kim and me.
Thank you.
Not just, you know, size zero women.
Y'all look gorgeous today. And they're here to outfit Nancy for her 16th
college reunion.
Here we go.
It's true. It's been 16 years. So the
kind of clothes... Where are you going to take?
All right. Well, what I was thinking of taking, because I'm basically still the hippie I was then, was like this linen shirt that's kind of brown and, you know, wrinkling isn't awesome. I don't know why you're making that face. And then I was thinking, you know, if there's a picnic or something like that, I might wear like a light kind of thing, because there'll be a lot of like picnicking and stuff. And then this is my old Oberlin sweatshirt.
You still have
from
it?
16 years ago.
Did you have all of these when you were there
before?
Oh,
gee.
No.
Okay. Obviously, there's a problem. So what should I be taking? What are you trying to tell me?
Well, how about what you have on now? Can you stand up and let us see that?
I can't be Dana Buckman
without the, I don't know if you need the diamonds.
I like the diamond accessories. Okay, let me move those out of the way. So this
is... do that twirl thing that you didn't want to do in rehearsal.
Oh, God.
Work it out.
No, all right, that's it. No, I like this. It's comfortable, and will it travel well? I mean, is it going to wrinkle if I...
Absolutely not. It's washed silk. And what's great about it is it looks fabulous on you, but it also wears well. It's a little sensual. It's easy to move in.
Sensual's nice.
Sensual. We love sensual.
Thank you.
And, you know, when you go to your reunion, you should kind of... I think you want to give the appearance that you're successful. You're your best self.
Yeah, that's...
You know,
of course
you want to
put
that forward. You don't want to be the one they say, oh, look what happened to her. You want to be like, oh, look at her.
Exactly.
Nancy. Like,
okay, well, these were just thoughts from before. All right. So clearly they're not going to work. So let's see some of the other things that you guys were going to recommend that that I wear. Let's
well, what
see.
Kim's well, wearing
Kim
is looking
terrific.
I didn't know I was going to get to
She's
work it.
She's wearing a pistachio. Oh, you should do that sachet too,
a pistachio. You know what a reunion is? It's a bad catalog model. But it's also separates that work well and look great, and you can wear things with other things, and you have this in the store right now, correct?
We do, and it's color. You know, we New Yorkers often don't think of color. It's usually black
and
white.
But here we are.
Black doesn't show dirt.
That's
you wear it over and over and over and over again. Nobody knows.
Nope, you'd be surprised how many women across the country will say, oh, I can't wear that color. And I said, just try it a little.
All right.
Just put it on.
I was
one. We were having this conversation, and she said, no, I've never thought of green. Oh, I'd never.
It looks great.
I
love
she's radiant with this
great
color.
The other important thing to remember is pack clothes that work together. Okay.
And we love the pistachio color worn with the brown you're wearing.
Oh.
It's a new combination, sort of.
I guess I'll be borrowing that jacket then.
I'll share.
I'll share.
Because, you know, brown instead of black warms things up, and it makes colors that you've seen for years look suddenly new again. Like everybody's seen a pastel,
okay,
but with brown, it takes on this
now we have
new
some more. Yeah, I want to see. I'm going to be performing, and I think you've got an outfit that I can move well in and feels comfortable.
Kate is actually wearing
Mommy,
Kate.
Kate, that's right.
Like to perform in pants, and
yeah,
these are relaxed trousers, and they're in a
beautiful
disco fabric. It also performs well, moves on the stage.
That's right, Kate.
You look beautiful. And that's a great color combination.
It is.
Yeah,
see, now, that's how brown makes things look new.
Now, I notice there's another gorgeous outfit here worn by Allison.
This is for the Saturday night wedding.
That's very nice.
That's going to be
sweet
the
big girl.
Yeah. Yeah, just imagine me moving to the disco thing. That's gorgeous.
And Nancy, you've got long legs. I think you should put this skirt on and just work it.
All right, I will.
Okay.
Darn it all, I sure will. That's beautiful, Allison.
Great. And then if it gets cold,
I've never seen Allison. I've known Allison for 3 years. I've never seen. I got to go to the bathroom.
Oh, this is great. So the whole point is just to sort of be who I am, but just updated with, you know, comfortable fabrics and rich-looking things and appear like I'm, you know, incredibly successful and very sensual,
and
right?
Take the diamonds.
Of course.
And the headphones.
All right.
Wear that with everything.
All right, thanks.
Okay.
I really feel armed for bear. Thank you, ladies. And I don't know, what happens next time?
Well, actually, you're not fully armed.
I'm not, huh?
All you have dealt with, Nancy Giles, is the exterior stuff, right?
Oh, yeah.
Right? I mean,
first impression.
That's right. But once you open your mouth, all of the traumas, all of the neuroses may come spilling out again at Oberlin College.
So true.
And that's why Sheena Henkin, our own Fox After Breakfast shrink, will shrink you on live television when we continue to Ready Nancy.
Oh, God.
For the reunion.
Some waffles?
Waffles? Are you crazy? I don't have time for waffles.
You do if they're Eggo Cinnamon Toast waffles.
Try them.
Where's the butter and syrup?
Are you crazy? You don't have time for butter and syrup.
They're the first waffles with a baked-in sweet cinnamon taste. So they're great even without butter and syrup.
What's eating, Dad?
Waffles.
Are you crazy? You don't have time for waffles.
Eggo Cinnamon Toast waffles. Hey, you've got time for waffles.
Everyone knows we give away millions on Super Bowl Sunday.
I just won $10 million.
Now we're bringing Super Bowl excitement to summer.
August 14th, publicist Turinghouse will surprise a new $1 million winner live on TV. Enter now and it could be you.
We're running to Payless to get shoes for the beach.
There's a beachwear sale at Payless with these cool styles for your family.
Honey?
Doesn't it feel good to pay less?
Trusting the wrong diarrhea medicine can put you in a very uncomfortable position. But you can count on Imodium AD to stop diarrhea often in one dose. You could end up taking dose after dose after dose of the pink stuff to stop diarrhea as effectively as Imodium AD. Don't take chances with diarrhea.
You should have taken Imodium AD.
Take Imodium AD.
Sorry.
One dose relief you can count on.
I say, clean your room. They say, already did. I say, go to sleep. They say, why? I pick my battles, but not on important stuff like teeth. My teeth? Of course they're healthy. I'm a Crest kid, so my Crest kids use Crest cavity protection. Some cavity-prone places can weaken. That's where Crest fluoride penetrates, and over time, can strengthen them. And strong teeth help build strong kids.
Behind that healthy smile, there's a Crest kid.
Fox presents an all-new special.
I try to make world peace, but if that doesn't work, I take over the universe.
The funny things kids do, Sunday at 7, 6 Central on Fox.
Come on over to Fox After Breakfast with special guest co-host Kim Coles. From The Young and the Restless, actor Peter Bergman drops by. Fitness expert Patricia Moreno has tips for posture. Plus, the hip-hop, jazz, and soul band, Brand New Heavies, get us dancing. Brighten your day with Fox After Breakfast. Tomorrow.
One of the things, Kelly, we think is important for Nancy as she gets set to go back to Oberlin is the psychological profile, is resetting the ambiance as much as possible so that she's ready for it. It's like,
ready for anything
like
that
acting.
Happens.
It's like role play.
It's like you pulling a commercial out of my past.
Kind of like that. Yes, it is. Now Nancy Giles is with Sheena Henkin for the psychological part of her preparation.
Yes, because frankly, I'm losing my mind, and our brilliant resident shrink, Sheena Henkin, is going to take me through what I can expect when I go back to my 16th college reunion. I'm scared.
Well, this is the worst moment, Nancy. The anticipation. That's when you're really suffering. So calm down.
Look, okay, let's
stop thinking about your feelings.
I'm thinking about myself, is what you're saying, right?
Other people we're going to focus on.
Okay.
Breathe slowly. We're going to make the big entrance now.
Okay, we're going through the threshold.
Calm down. We're going to rock and roll through this one.
Okay?
Let's
go. All right.
Calm down.
I'm
don't
calm.
Think about you. Go.
All right.
Come on.
Oh, boy.
Keep confident, keep
all
walking.
Right.
Focus on other people. Here Here we go. Pick up your name.
Okay.
Nancy.
Here's my Nancy Giles. These are the kind of things that are frightening.
Don't compare yourself to other people. Just think about other people being here, having fun.
Well, why do people compare themselves?
Well, teenagers do that. They don't know who they are. They're trying to find out. They have this kind of comparison thing. Am I popular? Is she better looking than me?
Right.
And they often put themselves down and feel stupid, unattractive, and dumb. You know those kind of feelings.
Right.
A familiar place, familiar old feelings. So come on. We're not going to do that. No self-criticism.
Okay.
Not allowed.
Now, one of the things I did was I planned to come with friends of mine from the past. Is that a good idea?
It's a very good idea, but not everybody can do that.
Right.
So when you get here, what you're going to do right now is walk tall, look around the room, see if anybody familiar to you.
Okay.
Any familiar faces, because we feel comfortable with people we know.
Should I role play?
Yeah, sure. Look around the room.
My old best friend, Stephanie. Hi. She looks great. So
look around.
Like
just keep with anybody else you know
right.
around. You look right around.
Oh, my God, my first boyfriend. Now, Sheena, what happens if this happens? He's just as unfriendly as he was before. What do I do with somebody
Well, then you say, it was nice to see you again, and walk away, and don't think about it. Come
on. Nice to see you again.
Yeah. Don't think about it.
I want my record collection back.
All right.
How are you doing now?
I feel a little bit better.
Right.
Focusing on other people helps.
Right. Right. First, the second thing to do is focus on people you don't know.
Yeah, like the back row.
Because after all...
Oh, my God! Wait, they've brought back real friends from my past. Sean! This is my friend Sean Banner, who's a brilliant illustrator. Vina, get out of here!
Oh, my God!
My friend Barb.
My pal's gonna be
I really haven't seen them and like, this is embarrassing, but a warm and wonderful moment. I'm fine. So what will I just talk to them?
Of course you'll talk to them. But don't forget, you can do that later. There are people here you don't know. And, you know, teenagers are obnoxious, and when they grow up, they become wonderful.
We weren't obnoxious.
You were obnoxious.
We were great.
We
were wonderful people.
But, you know, people you didn't like, who didn't thought you weren't cool, go up to them now and say, I'm Nancy Giles. Good to see you again.
I'm Nancy Giles. Good to see you again, Barb.
You again.
Hi, Zeno. Nancy Giles. Good to see you again.
Yes,
Sean,
people you
Sean, good to see you again.
Go meet the
stranger.
Oh, okay.
Come on.
Well, that's what
later,
I'm going to do.
Later. Come on, do that.
Okay.
Because you might like them now.
Hello.
Today,
so nice to
Nancy
see you.
Nancy Giles.
Giles.
I see you on fire. And here's cool Kim, who never spoke to you when you were in college.
I was an exchange student. Very nice to see you. Very good to see you again.
Okay.
Very good.
She speaks fluent Japanese.
Thank you. Very good to see you.
So the tendency to just hang with familiar people, I should break that.
Give us an opportunity to make friends with people who you had nothing in common with at one time, but they grew up, Nancy.
Now, I have one more psychological fear. I'm doing a show that I sort of talk about the school. I sort of trash certain institutions that were there. So I'm feeling a little insecure about doing that at the scene of the crime. What would you suggest?
You're making the most common psychological error. You care what other people think?
All right.
I get it.
Okay.
Don't care what
other people
think. Do what you think is right.
All right.
Just all right.
Okay. Is there anything I should go over? No, food. I won't be eating at all. That won't.
Yeah, and I think the bottom line, too, is if you got a $4 million diamond, just flaunt it. Just stick it right in their face.
Oh, hi. That's okay.
But everyone should go to the high school college reunion. Everyone
Why
should go.
That?
Yeah, because we should all do what we're afraid of. Make a list of what you're afraid of and do it. If you're scared, get over it.
Sheena Hankin with those three words that always work for all of us.
She's built a lucrative practice with just that.
One
get
phrase, Tom. One phrase.
We'll be right back after this. Very nice.
Fox After Breakfast is brought to you by Diet Coke. You are what you drink.
When we welcome Peter Bergman, who's Jack Abbott on The Young and the Restless, garden expert, CZ guest, and brand new heavies with a live outdoor concert right here on Fox After Breakfast.
Okay. Sinbad. Suzanne Wong and the Dancing Dogs at the Big Apple Circus. A fine performance, Suzanne.
Thank you to Johnny Pierce and Peggy O'Neill. This is Tiger, and the rest of the dogs are getting ready for the big show at 11:15. See you tomorrow with Jack Hanna.
All right, great. And also Kelly Rutherford about to embark on a trip to Gay Perry. We've given
you
everything you
need
to know.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Look for Kelly on Melrose Place or teaching French at a school near you. Sheena Henkin, thanks for helping Nancy Giles out. I think she's psychologically prepared for Overland College. Dana Buckman, Karen, thank you so much to all of your friends. It was a nice surprise to have everybody there.
This is what I mean. Everything's changed. Oh.
Take care, folks. Have a great day. We'll see you tomorrow on Fox After Breakfast.
Yes.
Mingle. You guys mingle.
Wait, they're on TV. Wait.